All right. Well, also today, the State House of Representatives passed a bill saying that they will stop the revolving door on criminals who bond out. It's something that law enforcement has mentioned as being a problem in recent years, but not everybody agrees that this is the right solution. News 19's Becky Buds is at the State House with more.
South Carolina will not tolerate or enable a revolving door of reoffenders.
House Republicans, solicitors, and law enforcement celebrating the passage of a new bond reform bill.
If we have one more tool that protects one more life while affording the due process that's important to all of us, we need to do it.
The proposal would revoke bond for people who commit a violent crime while out for another violent offense. If a person is convicted of a second violent crime while on bond, an extra 5 years of prison would be tacked on to their sentence. Supporters say it will make it harder for people who commit violent crimes to get out on bond and deter people who do get out from committing more crimes.
Yeah, and so I don't really see when the criminal's rights trump the rights of the law-abiding citizens.
Many Democrats oppose the bill, arguing it interferes with citizens' rights to due process.
The Supreme Court has already spoken on this issue. You cannot simply add time to somebody's sentence and not give them a right to a jury trial on that time.
Others worry about the impact on prisons.
Our prisons that are understaffed, by the way, our prisons that are in horrible conditions.
Law enforcement, including Lexington County Sheriff Jay Kuhn, disagree.
Everybody that manages a jail like I do realizes, you know, the sacrifices are worth it because at the end of the day, it's about the safety of the community. So.
The bill now heads to the Senate, where lawmakers are considering their own version of bond reform. At the State House, Becky Buds, News 19 WLTX.
Thank you, Becky. And according to the Department of Corrections, the annual total per inmate was $32,000 last year.